let's graph the equation y equals x squared. And we're going to do this by making a table of values. So when we make our table of values for y equals x squared, we can put any number in for x and we'll get a value for y that would be on the line here for our equation. But in practice, we want to choose values of x that are going to end up giving us values of y that actually fit on our graph paper. So I'm going to start out and say, how about 2, 1, 0, negative 1, and negative 2. So I think these values should be somewhere on the graph here. When I do that, I have x is 2. So when I put 2 in for x, 2 squared, that's 2 times 2, we get 4. If I put 1 in for x, that's 1 squared. 1 times 1 is 1. If we put 0 in for x, 0 times 0 is 0. And here's kind of the interesting part. Negative 1. If I put a negative 1 in for x, negative 1 times negative 1, that's going to give me a positive 1. Negative 2. Negative 2 times 2 gives me a positive 4. So you can see we kind of have a bit of a mirroring going on with our y values. So these are the values that we'll graph for the equation y equals x squared. So let's start out. We have 2 for x, and then y is 4. So 1, 2, and we go up to 4. That's our first point. Then we have x is 1, y is 1. X is 1, y is 1, 0, 0. That's right here at the vertex. Negative 1, 1. So negative 1, and we go up to 1 there. And finally, negative 2 for x, and then 4 for y. Since we still have some space here, if we put 3 in for x, we'd have 3, that would be the x, and then 3 squared is 9. So we go over 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 9 here. And if we put negative 3 in for x, negative 3 times negative 3, that's still 9. So that gives us a little bit more here on our graph. Now, if we were to take a line here and connect all of these points, this is the graph for y equals x squared. Let's extend these up a little bit. And we'll put arrows to show that this goes to infinity. Even though it's gone off our graph paper, you can imagine more graph paper up here. So this is our graph for y equals x squared. It's a parabola. It's symmetrical along the y-axis. We have the vertex here at 0, 0. So a table of values, it's kind of a useful way for us to be able to draw the graphs of these equations like y equals x squared. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.